In this video, I'm going to review with you how data is handled in C, particularly reviewing the primitive data types, arrays, and strings. Let's see. The language C defines 5 primitive data types in float, double, char, and void. You will remember those keywords from Java. As we mentioned before, there is not Boolean data type in C. C++ will add later the type bool, not Boolean, just bool. One big difference with Java is that C and C++ define what they call modifiers. These keywords, signed, unsigned, short, and long, can be used in the left side of a type, and they are going to change the characteristic of the type. As you can see, using modifiers, the 5 data types in C become 15 different choices for the type of a variable. What is going to change is the values that you can store in a variable for a particular type. For instance, some of the options you can use or not negative numbers. If you do not use negative numbers, then you have more options for positive values. For instance, an unsigned char is 0 to 255, but if you use signed char, you have only half of the values negative and half of the values positive. In some cases, the values depend on the computer. For instance, if you use char, depending on the computer, you can be able to store negative numbers or not. That is something that do not happen in Java, because remember, Java have the virtual machine. But here, you are dealing with the computer itself. You can notice that the characters, the size is 1 byte, 8 bits. And that is because C uses characters in ASCII instead of using Unicode like Java. In Java, because we use Unicode, the characters are 2 bytes or 16 bits. A common characteristic of all the data types in C is that all of them are numeric, so all of them store numbers. That means that you can use arithmetic operators basically for everything. Even the bool type that is going to be included in C++. So, for instance, if you want to store the age of a person, that value is going to be kind of 0 to 100. You can use a char type for the variable age, because what you store in a char is a number. Moreover, as you saw in a previous example, any expression with any variable or value that is a number can be used as a condition. And the rule is that 0 is going to represent false, but any other number is going to represent true. Now, let's review arrays. As you can notice in the example, arrays in C are quite similar to the notion of array that you know from Java. You can create unidimensional arrays, bidimensional arrays, three-dimensional arrays, and so on. You can create the array empty, or you can initialize the array when you declare it. You can access the element of the array with the index, and we use the square bracket for both array declaration and accessing the data from the array. The only new thing is the instruction sizeof. Sizeof is going to allow you to get access to the size of the array. In Java, that was length, if you remember. Here, length is going to be sizeof. A really important thing to notice is that sizeof is kind of an operator, not a method. Therefore, if you notice, there are not parentheses after sizeof. So if you want to know the size of the array A, B, or MA, you use sizeof, space, and then the name of the array, like here. But you do not put parentheses to surround the name of the array. Again, sizeof is not a method. An important aspect to review in C, we do not have any primitive data type to represent strings. Strings are going to be equivalent to arrays in C. Therefore, in order to create a string, we are going to create an array. Notice that the declaration of S1 and S2 is exactly the same. Both are arrays of characters. However, in the first line, we are adding values to the array as we used to do for arrays in Java. one element in each position. In the second example here, we are initializing the array with a string, and the result is going to be quite different. When you use a string to initialize an array, that array is going to have one extra element, \0, that is a null character. Null characters are included at the end of a string to mark the end of the string. In the example, S1 have a size 5 because it have 5 elements as listed in the initialization. However, S2 have a size 6 because S2 have the same 5 elements, but also the null character in the last position of the array. These two lines here are equivalent. You can initialize the array with a string, or also you can put values in the array and include a last element with the null character. Something that is important to mention is that if you make what in Java is a mistake, adding a size to the array, like here, when you initialize the array with a value, the Java compiler will tell you that this is an error. However, C will allow you to do this, even though the result is gonna be this one. As you notice, even though you are using strings to initialize the array, because the arrays are too small, you are losing the null character. Therefore, S2 and S3 are not going to work like strings. Even though you are initializing S3 with alpha, some characters are not going to be included in the array. So the size that you indicate here between the square brackets have priority over the values. When you initialize an array with a string, you can print the full array with one printf instruction using the control symbol %s. Also, because it is an array, you can use a for loop and print character by character. In order to print a character, you use the control symbol %c. In the first case, you use the name of the array. In the second case, you use the name of the array, and also you need to provide the index for the character. Finally, I would like to review how C handles constant value. There are two options. You can use the keyword const, that is equivalent to the keyword final in Java. So if you put the keyword const before the declaration of a variable, the value that you store in the variable cannot change. In this example, the value for I is 5, and if you try to change that, that will be an error in compilation time. A second option is the use of the keyword char define. This keyword associates a label to a value. In this example, the label pi to the value 3.14. It is important to notice that this instruction do not have a semicolon at the end. Basically, what happened with this instruction is that the compiler is going to replace all the labels pi with the value 3.14 before doing the compilation process. Literally, this is going to be a search and replace process. And that's it. See you in the next video.